Yeah. You just my type, not just one night. Trying to do this right for the rest of my life. You don't know you're beautiful, what are you, blind girl? Smiling at the ground, you ain't gotta be shy, girl. Beautiful in and out.
Hi everybody, welcome back to Curvy Girl Makeup. Yeah. I know, I've been gone so long. Well, the problem was my husband got a new computer and all of my July videos got up late because he had to get a new editing program and had to learn how to use it. So all the July videos that I had were up late, and these are my August videos. And I was visiting my mom down in North Carolina for a week, and so I've been away for a while. But I'm back, and today I'm back with a haul, some of the stuff that I bought down in North Carolina while I was staying with my mom. And it's a combination of fashion and cosmetics. So let's get started. The first place that I'll start with is Rite Aid. I went down there and I had to pick up a couple things. And when I was in Rite Aid, I found some goodies that I have been wanting to pick up, but I haven't had a chance to find. So the first one is the Wet n Wild I'm Getting Sunburned palette. And it looks like this. And I've seen Cora from Vintage or Tacky use this, and I loved the tutorial that she did with it, so I wanted to pick it up, but I couldn't find it in a store around by me. So I will show you what the colors look like. They are absolutely gorgeous colors, and I will swatch them for you. I mean, they are like super pigmented, and we all know Wet n Wild's pigmentation, amazing. Love this palette. So I'm looking forward to using that and getting a good look with that. I also found the Cool as a Cucumber palette, and it looks like this. And it's got gorgeous greens and a purplish, dark purpley color. And these are what the colors look like. And I will swatch those for you. I mean, the green is gorgeous in here. The purple is beautiful. And the light green brow bone, I mean, absolutely beautiful colors. And that's just one swipe. Love Wet n Wild products. They are beautiful. So that is Cool as a Cucumber. So I'm looking forward to using this one as well. I'm going to go through looking for YouTube and see if I can find some looks of some people that have used that. I also picked up the Wet n Wild Fergie Take on the Day Eyeshadow Primer. It's it doesn't leave any color on your lids. It's a clear primer, but I've seen a lot of YouTubers use this, and they say it's wonderful, and I couldn't find it in any stores around here in Jersey, so I picked it up when I was down in North Carolina, so yay, I found that. And the last thing I picked up at Rite Aid was another Milani Color Statement lipsticks. And again, I couldn't find this one up here. And it's called number 20 Uptown Mauve. And this is what it looks like. It's a beautiful, gorgeous berry color. And I will swatch it for you. It's beautiful. Creamy, pigmented. Love these lipsticks. So this is going to be a good lipstick for the fall, so I'm looking forward to using that. So that's everything that I picked up at Rite Aid. I also stopped at Bed Bath & Beyond, and I went there purposely to look for this. This is the Hot Buns, Make a Beautiful Bun in Less Than a Minute. It's a kit where you can actually make one of those perfect-looking sock buns in your hair. And what it comes with is two of these little bun maker things. It comes with this one, comes with a large one, and it comes with a small one. So you can make two different size buns. And basically, well, my hair is already up, but basically what you do is you put your hair in a high ponytail and you take your hair and you wrap it and you roll it like this. And once you get it close to your scalp, you take it and you roll it over, and it has a little snap there. If I can get it to snap. Has a little snap. There you go. And it makes like a little bun. And what you do is then you separate your hair and you cut, take your hair all the way around it to cover this. And you have a perfect sock bun. So I saw it on TV and I went looking for it and I did find it down there. So I was really happy to find that. This one actually says it's for It says here for light hair. They didn't have one for brunettes, but I have a lot of hair, so I figured my hair would be thick enough to cover the whole apparatus here. So I wasn't worried about any of the color sticking through. So really looking forward to using this. Very happy I found it. I also went to a CCO. Now everybody knows the CCO is a cosmetic company outlets. And I found some MAC stuff that I wasn't able to find because they were already limited editions that were sold out. So gotta love the CCOs. And what I picked up there was one of the Marilyn Monroe shades. I was missed out on this collection, so I was glad to find it. And this one's an eyeshadow, and it is not wanting to come out of the box. Okay. It is Preferred Blonde, and it has the packaging Marilyn Monroe on the front. My brother, I have a brother, the oldest brother, passed away. God, it has to be almost 10 years ago. And he was a big Marilyn Monroe freak. He was wonderful. Actually, my brother was a drag queen, so he would always try and dress up like Marilyn. If he could be here, he would have. God bless him. I miss him so much. But I kind of bought this in honor of him because he loved Marilyn. And this is the color. It is a champagne-y, sparkly color. I will swatch it. It is gorgeous. Super pigmented. Awesome. Beautiful color. I'm thinking this would be good for when you want one of those frosty highlights on the lid or in the corners of the eyes to open up your eyes. Beautiful. Love that. I was glad I found it. I also picked up two pigments. I don't know if these pigments are discontinued or not, but this one is called Magenta Madness. And this one's beautiful. I'm not going to swatch these because they'll go all over the place, but you can see the color. It's a gorgeous, bright magenta color. Love this. These are good for, I know summer's almost over, but there's no rules in makeup. I wear all colors all year long. Doesn't matter to me. And I also bought, this one is from, I don't even know what the collection is. You can see it's some kind of Chinese writing. But it is blue, Reflex Blue. I've been looking for the Reflex Pink pigment, but the problem is if I look on YouTube, I mean, not YouTube, eBay, they want like super amount of money for it, and I'm not going to pay that much. But this one is, it's a white color, but it has blue flecks in it. It will shine blue in the light. That's what these, they have Reflex Gold, which is a white pigment that has gold flecks in it, and the Reflex Pink, it has shines pink. I love these. These are wonderful. So I was really happy to find at least the Reflex Blue. And the last thing I picked up at the CCO was a MAC lipstick. And it is in the color Honey Love. Now, I've been looking for this at my local MAC. I don't know if this was a limited edition or not, but I couldn't find it anywhere. And I actually found it at the CCO, so I was kind of happy to find it. And it is, of course, a nude, because I love my nudes. Beautiful color. I'll swatch it for you. It almost reminds me of Kinda Sexy, but Kinda Sexy is a matte, and this one's like a, this one's a matte, actually. Wow. It looks a lot shinier than a matte would. So, actually, let me get Kinda Sexy. Actually, I have Kinda Sexy on today, and I will swatch Kinda Sexy next to it. So they're quite similar. Kinda Sexy is a little bit more pinky peach, and I have the Kinda Sexy on today. Love this one. So I was glad to finally find Honey Love. Who was I watching? Love Blend and Beauty, Rachel, she wears this one a lot, and I loved it, so I was glad to find it. Thank you, Rachel, for the recommendation. Love that lipstick. So the next place that I went to was Ulta, and I have not been to an Ulta in, I can't even tell you how long. I usually shop at Sephora because I like the rewards that you get at Sephora better than the rewards at Ulta. But while I was down there, I decided to go to Ulta, and not a huge bag, but it's heavy. So the stuff that I got down at Ulta well, what's making the bag so heavy was the Japanesque brush cleaner, professional brush cleaner. I like this stuff. It actually has a nice citrus smell to it. I'm almost out of the Cinema Secrets that I bought when I was up at IMATS, so I actually just picked this up because I have used this in the past and it really works well, so I was needing that. The next thing that I found was the limited edition brushes by Samantha Chapman, The Real Techniques. These are the skunk brushes or the dual fiber brushes. I was ecstatic because, again, I can't find this stuff here in New Jersey. So they had it down in the Ulta in North Carolina, Burlington actually. So I will show you what they look like. And these brushes are so soft and so lovely. This is the Duo Fiber Face Brush, and it is a so soft, nice, love this brush. So this is the face brush. The next one is the Duo Fiber Contour Brush, and it looks like this, and it's like perfect. I mean, you can use this for anything. You use it for setting your concealer, for contour, for highlight. I mean, these brushes are like multi-use brushes. And the last brush that comes in this kit is not wanting to come out of the box. Okay. It is the Duo Fiber Eye Brush, and it looks like this. I mean, perfect blending brush. I have very deep set eyes, so it's my crease is kind of very deep set. So this is small, and it's like perfect just to get into the crease for me, because I need a small crease brush to get in there. So loving this. Can't wait to use these brushes. So I was happy to find those. The next thing I picked up is some NYX stuff, and I haven't tried them. Make sure I got them all out of the bag. The slide-on, glide-on pencils, I got a bunch of them. This one is purple, and it looks like this, and the swatch. I mean, they're like, they glide right on. They're great brushes. I mean, brushes. I haven't filmed in a long time. I'm like so out of it. Liners. This one is Black Sparkle. And it looks like that. Typical black. And it's supposed to have some sparkle in it. Maybe a little sheen to it. That's the black one. And from what I hear from all you YouTubers out there, they have great staying power. So I'm looking forward to using them. This one is, let me see, Sunrise Blue, and it looks like that, and I will swatch it. Gorgeous colors. I mean, it doesn't take much effort to get the color to show up either. This one is Tropical Green, and the swatch looks like that. Oh, God, they're like butter. Love these. They're like butter. Butter, butter, butter. And I picked up two lip pencils. This one is Pale Pink. And I think I already have this one, but it's okay because I use a lot of nude stuff, so for me, it won't go to waste. And that's the color. And the last one I picked up is Natural 08. And I think I actually have this one too. I didn't remember like what ones I had. And it almost is a little bit darker, brownier, but almost just like the Pale Pink. So excited about using these. Excuse me, I'm like dying of thirst. Love my Coca-Cola. Okay, those are all the pencils. I did pick up a makeup setting spray, Urban Decay All Nighter. And this is the first time I've picked this up in a long time, because right now I'm using the Kat Von D Locket spray. This one's okay. I like the way it smells. And I also have the Skindinavia one, which is the one I picked up at IMATS. But I haven't had this one, and I go through a lot of setting spray. And I've used Urban Decay in the past, so they have new packaging. I was quite surprised. I kind of like the old packaging with the city in the background, but this is the new packaging. So I picked up one of these. And I also picked up the new Benefit blush. It's called Rockateur. I don't know. I've actually, I saw Nicole Guerrero use it in her last tutorial. And it's funny because this is brand new and I hadn't seen anybody else using it. And I bought it and voila, there she is. She's using it. But it is beautiful. And again, smells so good. And you could see the inside and it has rock on the imprinted on the blush. And it is this gorgeous rose gold color. I mean, you could see the sparkle in it. It is beautiful. And I will swatch it for you. It's a subtle pink, but it has gorgeous shimmer. Oh my God, beautiful. Can't wait to use it. And that's what that looks like. Absolutely beautiful. So that was everything I picked up at Ulta. And I came home to a surprise in the mail. While I was out visiting my mom, I was watching YouTube and I saw Time the Infamous. Now everybody probably knows Time the Infamous. And I saw her do her latest tutorial and she used the Take Me to Brazil palette and I fell in love with it. I actually ordered it from Benefit while, BH Cosmetics while I was at my mom's. So this is what the palette looks like. Absolutely beautiful artwork, gorgeous. And inside, of course, you have a mirror. Hello. You have a pretty good sized mirror. And then you have, this is your palette. Absolutely gorgeous colors. I mean, and I know, again, summer's coming to an end, but I wear colors all year long. I'll swatch a couple. This is absolutely beautiful. Lime green, I mean, unbelievable. Pigmented colors. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. This purple over here, absolutely beautiful. The hot pink over here, love it. I mean, look at the pigmentation on these. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. So when I got home, I got a little present in the mail. It was funny because my brother lives with us and he texted me and said, "You got a package in the mail." And I was like, "Who's it from?" He said, BH Cosmetics. And I was like, "Ooh, my Brazil palette's here." So it actually got to my house before I even got back. So those are all the cosmetic items I picked up while I was there. And I did a little bit of clothes shopping. Now, we went to the Harley dealership in Burlington. And we usually go there every year because I do go see my mom every year. My mom's 80 years old, God bless her soul. And she lives in North Carolina. She's far away. So I try to get down there at least once a year to see her. So we went to the Harley Davidson down home in Burlington, North Carolina. And I actually picked up one of my headbands. These are... I'm sure you've seen motorcycle riders, they wear those do-rags that tie in the back. I don't like those. I like the ones that have the stretchy. So what I do is when I put it over my head, I put this part underneath my ponytail or braid so it stays on. And it actually keeps my hair down so I don't get helmet head. And if it's hot out and you sweat, it absorbs any sweat. So this is the do-rag that I picked up for myself. And I picked up a black one for my bestie. And it's exactly the same, but the material is black instead of white. So I picked up one of these. Never have enough of those. And I got this awesome shirt. It's a Giddy T-shirt, and it has Harley Davidson on the front. And on the bottom here in the corner, it says, where is it? Right here, it says, Down Home Harley, Burlington, North Carolina. But the back of this shirt, you ready? This shirt is kick-ass. This is the back of the shirt. I love it. It's like, hi. I love this shirt. When I saw this, I fell in love with it. It was $65. I know, a bit pricey, but when I saw the back of this shirt, I had to have it. So, treated myself to this shirt. And that's what I picked up at Harley. And I went to Lane Bryant, you know, because I rock it for the big girls. So I picked up a few shirts there. I actually got a couple guinea tees that were just like aqua and plain. So they weren't anything exciting. And I actually got this one. Let me see if you can see it. I'll pan down. It says rock and roll guinea tee. Love this one. And I picked up a couple sleeve shirts. Yeah, and... again, winter's coming, I know, but I don't ever wear a long sleeve shirt. I wear short sleeves all year long. I can't stand long sleeves. So I picked up this one, It has skulls on it, and it says beautiful emotion and affective state of consciousness, the quality present in a person or thing. And it's kind of beachy looking with skulls. Love it. Of course, what biker doesn't love skulls, right? I also picked up this one. This one's kind of like a jean wash color, like washed out jeans, and it's got a picture of a sugar skull on it. Love this one, and it's kind of studded, so love that one. And the last one I got is purple, and it has a big heart and two skulls looking at each other. You know, I guess even skulls need love, right? And it's got like crystals all over it. So, love these shirts. My mother was like, what are you wearing all skulls for? I was like, I don't know, I like skulls. You know, bikers wear skulls, what could I tell you? But that was my entire haul from North Carolina. I hope you enjoyed. And I actually was glad that I got some clothes down there because I have a whole bag of clothes that I have to bring to the Goodwill because I have lost a total of 342 pounds. Amazing, I know. If you want to hear my weight loss story, comment in the comment section below and let me know that you want to hear it. And I'll make a video dedicated to my weight loss story. But I needed some new clothes because I had to get rid of a lot of my old ones. So I was glad I was able to pick up all those shirts and stuff. So yeah, that's the entire haul. I hope you enjoyed. Please remember to thumbs up the video. Oh, before I forget, my husband will shoot me. There is a, and you've probably seen it before in the down bar, stuff called Beauty on the Sea. It is a 5-night cruise to Bermuda from, I think it's Bayonne, New Jersey, and it's called Beauty on the Sea, and it is a beauty expo. Some of your favorite YouTubers will be going. It is a fundraiser for Base Camp for Children, to help raise money for cancer research. And yeah, it's just everybody gets together and have a good time. You can set sail and cruise with some of your favorite YouTubers. If you want more information, click on the link below, Beauty on the Sea, and it'll give you information on who's going and the itinerary and all that stuff. So yeah, please check it out. It's for a good cause, and I'm sure it'll be a good time. Okay, so yeah, hope you enjoyed, and remember, beauty comes in all sizes, and I'm rocking it for the big girls. See you next time, bye. Like nobody else. The way that you flip your head gets me overwhelmed. The way you smile like the ground, it ain't hard to tell.